What's up, everybody, and welcome to Maximize the Business of You. I'm Maximino, and today I have some special guests all the way from Dallas, Texas. They are the co-founders of a branding company called Motto.
Rising up, here we go. No time to be afraid. They say it's impossible. And listen to what they say. They got me motivated.
We have Sunny Bonnell and Ashleigh Hansberge. Thank you for being here.
Thank you.
I really appreciate you being on Maximize.
Yeah.
And you know, Maximize is all about helping people maximize their potential. So this topic right here is really, really I think important for a lot of people because branding is so big.
Yeah.
It's so important. So this topic is all about branding. We have two experts in the house. They've been in business since 2005. So please tell us your story, please. How did you guys get started?
Sure. So we started Motto in 2005. In a small fishing village in South Carolina, grew it very early on from $250 to multi-million dollar company. Now we work with a lot of challenger brands and corporate companies who are going through periods of growth and transition, help them disrupt the market and build a narrative for themselves.
Awesome. Mm-hmm. So what made you say, we want to start a branding company? 2005, you know, there was no Facebook. Branding was still important for big corporations, but branding is so important for everybody. Personal brands, small businesses. Everybody needs to really have a voice, especially if you run a business.
Yeah.
So what made you say, we're going to tackle branding?
Yeah. Well, we really started off in the design space and quickly realized that, wow, brand is so much more than design. It's so much more than what something looks like and what it feels like, but it's kind of that whole essence of who you are as an organization. Mm-hmm. So we quickly sort of transitioned from just a design shop into a branding agency with a very sort of purposeful, centric, essence about the work that we do and who we are. And it was very humble beginnings, you know, eating ketchup sandwiches and not having two pennies thrown together into, you know, something that is more impactful than that. So yeah, it was something that I feel like we've always had a passion for, you know, being in design and branding and culture and commerce. It's just, we love the work that we do. And it just became a really effortless transition from just design into the world of branding.
Awesome. So you guys been featured in People Magazine, People to Watch, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
You write for Inc.
Soon enough, I'm sure.
You write for Inc., Forbes. So how did that stuff come about?
Sure. Well, I think we early on started to have, because we had never worked for another agency, so back to your question, we had never worked for another agency, so it made it really easy for us to kind of make our own rules. And I think because we saw an opportunity where companies weren't really distinguishing themselves from other organizations, we felt that there was a gap and a real need for that. And so I think that kind of no guts, no glory attitude and trying to disrupt our own category allowed us to kind of see that wide open space and just go for it, you know, and try to make a name for ourselves. And I think by putting our point of view out there, we just started getting a lot of attention because it was unlike other people in the category.
Gotcha. You know? Awesome. So what would you, give me some 5 tips on people that are starting out in business right now or starting their personal brand. What if 5 things they should be doing off the back to start positioning themselves in the right way?
Right. Well, I think number one, I think they should ask themselves, what is their story and why does it matter? Because there's a lot of companies out there and a lot of personal brands all kind of saying the same thing. So you need to understand how to encapsulate what is really truly unique about you and be able to articulate in a way that you can communicate that to other people. That's first and foremost. If you don't have or know your story or can't articulate your story, that's like a very foundational element for anybody trying to start a company, start a personal brand, build a brand. Got to know their story and know what they're trying to communicate to the world.
Mm-hmm. Number 2?
I would say ignore your rivals.
Mm.
You know, we get
competitors.
So caught up in this idea of what is everybody around me in my space doing? And it paralyzes companies a lot in making their own decisions, being their authentic selves, kind mm-hmm. of getting out there in the world and making those bold moves. And it can kind of straighten you back out into the world of where all the normal brands and normal people go. And mm-hmm. I think our thing is ignore your rivals and do something really extraordinary.
Right, disrupt. I mean, that's really big
yeah.
on your website, so that you guys are mm-hmm. really branding for people that are disrupting
oh, yeah.
themselves and disrupting mm-hmm. whatever field they're in.
That's right, that's yeah. right, yeah.
Another tip?
Number three, I would say, which is a big one for us, is have a war cry or a motto. A lot of people use that as like a mission statement. We don't believe in those. I think they're usually like phrases or statements that companies come up with that nobody pays attention to, nobody remembers. And a war cry is really important because it's kind of the linchpin for what you go to battle every day with.
Right.
So when you think of a motto, you think of something like a
yeah.
short, simple phrase.
Give me something. Yeah.
Oh, well, ours is fortune favors the bold. So everything that we do
fortune
is...
Fortune favors the bold.
Absolutely. I mean, we know that there's no reward without putting your neck out and being risk, and so that's what we live by.
So like mine would be the business of you.
Yeah, yeah.
Right, maximize the
yeah.
business
sure.
of you.
Yeah, yeah. And so, everything needs to be centralized around that.
So guys, you see, I'm learning as well. So
absolutely. We'll teach you, take you to school.
Four, you have another one?
Yeah, I would say, you know, it's time to get really personal. Mm-hmm. So I think that there is something about who we are as leaders and entrepreneurs and business people and CEOs that it's kind of, you know, you have to be willing to like reveal yourself personally so mm-hmm. that you can make that really authentic personal connection mm-hmm. with your audience. So I pull back the curtains, let people kind of see behind
the real
scenes.
You.
The real yeah.
you.
Yeah. It's not, you know, your company, your business, your brand should not just be something external. It should be something within you and something internal that you can share with the world. So pull back those curtains.
Is this for personal? This is fourth advice. Is for personal brands
Both.
Or business brands?
Both. I think it's even more important. Personal brands, that's a given. Right.
Right.
But company brands and corporate brands, I think that is almost, it's not a given as much. And I think it should be so that you can get really real and authentic and just let people see behind the scenes and inside of you and your way of thinking, what your struggles are, what your challenges are. You know, open yourself up in that way so that people can connect with you on a more emotional level.
Mm-hmm. Awesome. Mm-hmm. One more, five.
More. Absolutely invest in brand. We see a lot of companies and startups make the mistake of not putting enough resources, time, energy, and money towards building their brand. If anything, they put all of their effort in product development,
yep.
not enough in the brand. And the biggest mistake that we see is companies who don't value brand and understand the power and the significance
of it. So how would they, what would be an example of investing in their brand? Like you said, a lot of people focus on product but forget about brand. What would, this is part of what we're yeah. talking about, the
yeah.
five keys.
Yes.
It's kind of the same thing when sure. you mean investing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. I mean, well, you know, like if you have a product, you know, everybody puts all of their money, you know, especially this
in the product.
In the product, you know, and then they're like, they wake up one day and go, oh my God, how am I going to sell this?
Right. So it's marketing and branding.
Yeah.
Kind of, sort of.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. I mean, it's all part of the same conversation. I think that it's really important to remember that anytime from the first moment you even start to think about your brand, your company, your product, whatever you're doing, you are starting to build your brand. And so I think it's never too early to start understanding and really investing, putting money into and taking care of your brand, your identity, your visual voice, your website. Like, don't throw pennies at it just because it's an afterthought.
Invest
in it.
Yeah.
You know, if you can, you know.
Yeah, it's like some companies will invest $100,000 in their product and try to go on like Fiverr or like 99designs and build in their brand. And you know, and every dollar, like when we first started out, every dollar we made went back into us, into our brand, into building our name, because we knew we were building more than just a company. We were trying to build a movement, an idea. It was beyond what we were trying to sell. We were trying to make something meaningful. And the only way that you can do that is by knowing the significance of brand and having it front and center at all times. Like, your eye always has to be on that.
Awesome. If you can share some resources or some books or maybe a website where people can go, and maybe it's your website too. You can go to wearemodel.com. Don't forget about that.
That's right.
But give me any books that you could recommend to my audience that may help them with their branding?
Sure.
That you could think of?
So there's a great book specifically about building brands. It's on several editions now. It is by Elena Weaver. Oh my gosh, why am I spacing her name? But it's called Designing Brand Identity. It's a fantastic resource book, tactical, practical resource book. Mm-hmm. But our other favorite, more aspirational, inspirational book of all times, which is one we give our clients, is called It's Not How Good You Are, It's How Great, How Good You Want to Be.
Ooh, I like that.
By Paul Arden, and it is fantastic. It's one of those books where you just pick up, you know, year after year and get something out of new every time you read it.
So when is your book coming out?
Oh, so we're in the throes of writing, and it's a very painful process, but it's rewarding, you know, because each chapter we get through, we're like, it's an accomplishment. So we're probably about 6 months to 8 months out. So hopefully the first of the year we'll
awesome.
Have it done.
Awesome. When you think of stellar brands or stellar personal brands, mm-hmm. who's the first people to come to, who are the first people to come to mind?
You know, Gary Vee.
Right, awesome.
Doing an awesome job
in the personal branding space.
Yeah,
I think he's certainly creating a wave. But there's a lot of, you know, you think of the big global giants like Starbucks and Apple, mm-hmm. and of course those brands, but there's a lot of up and coming, like, challenger brands that we're huge fans of. One is a company called Wild Fang that makes clothing for women that's targeted towards the tomboy market. So very much in my wheelhouse.
Nice.
Impossible Burger, a company that's doing really disruptive things. It's creating the Impossible Burger with a meat patty that's actually not meat.
But
tastes and smells like meat. Yeah. So
nice.
It's kind of interesting.
Interesting.
And gosh, who else? I mean,
so many
yeah.
people are out there.
Mario Armstrong, I think he's doing some cool stuff with
Never Settle.
Show. Yep.
That's pretty cool too. Yeah, that's pretty cool too. Can you guys share some apps that keep you guys productive that you use that you can share with my audience?
Yeah, absolutely. Well, there's tons of apps that we use for our business. We use Basecamp for our project management, which is great if you're in a type of business where you manage a lot of people or a lot of projects.
Basecamp.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
We use an app called Calendly for making appointments and scheduling appointments for us, which is great because it takes all the headache away from, when are you available? I'm between 1 and 4 and 2 and 3. And, you know, just you send somebody a link and they see your schedule and they book an appointment.
Awesome. What is that called again?
It's called Calendly.
Calendly. Yep. I like that. What? Anything else?
We use FreshBooks for invoicing.
Yeah.
FreshBooks?
I just downloaded Wunderlist, which has been awesome because you can just kind of give yourself, like, as I have ideas, book ideas, I just write everything down and set them aside. So
that's awesome.
It's a good one. Mm-hmm.
So where could my audience find more information about you guys? You can share the links, your websites.
Yep. So Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat at We Are Motto.
Yep. We Are Motto. Make sure you check them out. Thank you so much, you guys,
for
sharing some knowledge, some insight on branding. I really believe branding is super important for anybody trying to start a personal brand, a business. So I hope this was helpful for you guys. Remember to share, to like, and this is Maximize, y'all, the business of you. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Love you.
Thank you.